Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. And this is module number 1, Basics of Thermodynamics and Zeroth Law. And this is lecture number 7 on the module 1. We will be solving problems on the work and the heat here. And we recap from the previous lecture. In the previous lectures, we discussed about the work and the heat and the various equations for calculating work done in different processes. And we discussed about the heat and specific heat. And here we solve problems. And the learning outcome for the lecture is, at the end of the lecture, student will be able to solve problem on the work and heat. So the first example from the Anna University question paper, November 2019, a piston cylinder machine containing fluid system has a steering device as shown in the figure. The piston is frictionless and it is held down against the fluid due to the atmosphere pressure of 101.3 kilopascal. The steering device turned 9500 revolutions with an average torque against the fluid of 1.25 Newton. Meanwhile, the piston is of diameter 0.65 meter and moves with 0.6 meters. Find the work transfer for the system. So here there are two types of work. One is work given by the steering system and work produced by the reciprocating piston. And the work done by the steering device is 2 pi n t. So 2 pi t into n. So 2 into 3.14 into torque is 1.25 into revolutions 9500, which is 74,575 Newton meter, and this work is negative work as it is done on the system. The steering work is done on the system, it is negative. Work done by the movement of the piston, so W2 equal to P into A into L. So P into A is the force acting on the piston and L is the length moved by the piston. So A equal to pi by 4 d square. So 101.3 into pi by 4 into 0.65 square into 0.6 equal to 20.16 in 10 power 3 Newton meter. And this is positive work as the piston is doing the work. So this is work output from the piston. And net work done equal to W2 minus W1 equal to 20.16 in 10 power 3 minus 74,575 equal to minus of 51,415 Newton meter. So the work done, net work done is negative because the steering work is more than the work done by the piston. We take another example, similar example. A piston and cylinder machine containing fluid system has a steering device as shown in the figure. The piston is frictionless and it is held down against the fluid due to the atmospheric pressure of 101.32 kilopascal. The steering device is turned 10,000 revolutions with the average torque against the fluid of 1.275 Newton meter. Meanwhile, the piston is of 6 meter diameter, moves with 0.3 meter. So find out the net to work transfer for the system. And this is the diagram. The piston reciprocates 0.3 meter, diameter equal to 0.6 meter, and the pressure is 101.32 kilopascal. And again, the work done by the steering device, W1 equal 2 pi T into N. So 2 into 3.14 into 1.275 into 10,000, which is 80,070 Newton meter. So this is again negative work, as the work is done on the steering device. And work done by the movement of the piston, the similar equation. P A into L, so P into pi by 4 D square into L. So pressure is 101.32 pi by 4 into 0.6 square into 0.3, which is 8.59 10 power 3 Newton meter. So this is positive work as it is done by the piston. So the net work done equal to W2 minus W1, which is 8.59 10 power minus 3, 10 power 3 minus 80,070 equal to minus of 71,480 Newton meter. And the work net work done equal to minus of 71,480 Newton meter. Example 3, to a closed system, 150 kilojoules of work is supplied. The initial volume is 0.6 meter cube and the pressure of the system changes as P equal to 8 minus 4V, where P is pressure in bar, V is volume in meter cube. Determine the final volume and pressure of the system. So W equal to 150 kilojoules, V1 equal to 0.6 meter cube, initial volume is 0.6 meter cube, and work done is integral PdV. So very simple equation, integral PdV, and pressure is given by this expression 8 minus 4V. We substitute 8 minus 4V dV and we multiply by 10 power 5 because the pressure is expressed in bar. So bar 2 Nm per meter square, it is multiplying by 10 power 5. So 10 power 5 integrating this equation, 8V minus 4V square by 2 from 1 to 2. So 10 power 5, 8V2 minus 2V2 square minus 8V1 plus 2V1 square, and substituting all the values. So work done equal to minus 150 into 10 power 3 equal to 10 power 5 into substituting for V1, we have the value V1 equal to 0.6 and V2 is the unknown. So the last equation is taken to the next page. So minus 150 into 10 power 3 equal to 10 power 5 into 8V2 minus 2V2 square minus 8 into 0.6 plus 2 into 0.6 square, and simplifying we will get a quadratic equation in terms of for V2. So 2 minus 2V2 square plus 8V2 minus 2.58 equal to 0, and solving this equation, so V2 equal to minus B plus or minus root of B square minus 4AC by 2A using that equation, and you will get V2 equal to 3.645 or 3.355. The right answer is volume is 0.355 because the volume V2 will be less than V1. So V1 value is 0.6, so it is compression. So it is less than V1, so 0.6355, and final pressure equal to 8 minus V2. So P2 equal to final pressure 8 minus V2 0.355 equal to 6.58 bar. The answer to the problem, final volume is 0.355 meter cube and final pressure is 6.58 bar. And example number 4, a gas is compressed from initial volume of 0.42 meter cube to a final volume of 0.12 meter cube. During quasi-equilibrium process, the pressure changes with the volume according to the relationship P equal to AV plus B, where A is constant, minus 12,000 kilopascal per meter cube, and B equal to 600 kilopascal. Calculate the work done during the process. And again, write down the given data, V1 equal to 0.42 meter cube, V2 equal to 0.12 meter cube, A equal to minus 12,000, and B equal to 6,000 kilopascal. Once again, the work done equal to integral PdV. So the multiplying the equation by 100 because the pressure is given in kilopascal per meter cube. So A, B plus B into dV. So integrating A equal to minus 12,000, B equal to 600. So 100 minus 12,000 into V2 square minus V1 square by 2 plus 600 into V2 minus V1. And substituting all the values V1 and V2 and simplifying, the work done equal to 792 kilojoules. So the answer to the problem, work done equal to 792 kilojoules. Example number 5, during the expansion process, the pressure of a gas changes from 103 kilopascal to 689 kilopascal according to the relationship P equal to AV plus B, where A equal to 1230 kilopascal meter cube and B equal to a constant. The value is not given, you have to find out the B value. If the initial volume of the gas is 0.189 meter cube, calculate the work done during the process. So P1 equal to 103 kilopascal, P2 equal to 689 kilopascal, and A equal to 1230 kilopascal meter cube, and B1 equal to 0.189 meter cube. The value of the constant B, so we know the initial conditions, P equal to AV plus B, so P1 equal to AV1 plus B, substituting 103 kilopascal into 1230 into 0.189 plus B, so B equal to minus of 129.4 kilopascal, 47 kilopascal. Calculate the final volume V2, so the same equation you take, P equal to AV plus B. Now you substitute for P2, second condition, initial final condition, P2 equal to AV2 plus B. So V2 is the unknown, 689 kilopascal equal to 1230 into V2 minus 129.47, so V2 equal to 0.665 meter. Now, work done, W equal to integral PdV, so 100 is multiplied here because A, B are given in kilopascal, so AV plus B dV, and integrating and substituting limit, will get this equation like this, and substituting for V1 and V2, and simplifying, the work done equal to 188.4 kilojoules. So, the answer to the problem, 188.4 kilojoules. So listen to the integration, very simple integration, and substitute the constant, you'll get the answer. So you have to carefully substitute and use the calculator and to solve the problem. Example number 6, The properties of a closed system change according following the relationship PV equal to 3, where P is pressure in bar, V is volume in meter cube. Calculate the work done when the pressure increases from P1 equal to 1.5 bar and P2 equal to 7.5 bar. So P1 equal to 1.5 by 5 bar, P2 equal to 7.5 bar. And P1 V1 equal to P2 V2, so equal to 300 kilojoules. This is given 3, so P is given in bar, so this is in kilojoules. Now, work done, integral, so it is isothermal process, PV equal to constant, PV equal to constant a process, so work done equal to P1 V1, logarithmic of P1 by P2, so 300 into logarithmic of 1.5 divided by 7.5 equal to minus of 482.8 kilojoules. So work done during this process equal to minus of 482.8 kilojoules. Example number 7, this is from a 9SC question paper, May 2017. A gas of volume 0.014 meter cube expands polytropically from a pressure of 2.07 megapascal to 207 kilopascal. The polytropy exponent n equal to 1.35 determine the work done by the gas during the process, during the expansion. So V1 equal to 0.014 meter cube, P1 equal to 2.07 megapascal, P2 equal to 207 kilopascal, and n equal to 1.35. And final volume we calculate. So P1 V1 equal to P2, P1 V1 to the power n equal to P2 V2 to the power n. So V2 equal to V1 into P1 by P2 to the power 1 by n. So 0.014 into 2070 divided by 207 to the power 1 by 1.35 equal to 0.077. And work done for the polytropic process, W equal to P1 V1 minus P2 V2 divided by n minus 1. Substituting all the values. So everything, pressure in kilopascal, P1 is in kilopascal, volume. And P2 is in kilopascal, given as 207 kilopascal into volume V2 divided by 1.35 minus 1 equal to 37.26 kilojoules. And work done during the polytropic expansion process is 37.26 kilojoules. And a piston cylinder device containing 0.15 kg of air, initially at 2 megapascal and 350 degrees Celsius. The air is first expanded isothermally to 500 kilopascal. So according to the isothermally expanded, so 1 to 2 isothermal expansion, PV equal to constant, then compressed polytropically with a polytropy exponent of 1.2, so then it is compressed to 2 to 3, then finally compressed at constant pressure to the initial state, so 3 to 1 is the constant pressure process, so 1 to 2 is isothermal process, 2 to 3 is the polytropic process, 3 to 1 is the constant pressure process. Determine the boundary work for each process and the net work done for the cycle. So given value M equal to 0.15 kilogram, P1 equal to P3 equal to 2000 kilopascal, T1 equal to 350 degrees Celsius, which is 625 Kelvin, and the polytropic index equal to 1.2. Initial volume of the air from the perfect gas equation, V1 equal to MRT1 by P1. So calculating M equal to 0.15, R equal to 287 for air, temperature is 623, and pressure is 2 megapascal, 2 into 10 power 6, this is equal to 0.0134 meter cube. For the first process, 1 to 2 isothermal process, so V2 equal to final volume, V2 equal to P1 V1 by P2, this 2 into 10 power 6 into 0.0134 divided by 500 into 1000 equal to 0.0536 meter cube. Work done, W1T equal to P1 V1 into logarithmic of V2 by V1, which is 2 into 10 power 3 into 0.0134 into logarithmic of 0.0536 divided by 0.0134 equal to 37.15 kilonewton meter. For polytropic process, the final volume V3 equal to V2 into P2 by P3 to the power 1 by N. So substituting numerical values, this V3 equal to 0.0169 meter cube. And work done for the polytropic process, W23 equal to P2 V2 minus P3 V3 divided by N minus 1, and substitute numerical values, this is minus of 35 kilonewton meter. For constant pressure process, W31 equal to P3 into final volume minus initial volume, V1 minus V3, and this is again substitute numerical values, this is minus 7 kilonewton meter. So the constant work done for the cycle, W12 plus W13 plus W31, so 37.15 minus 35 minus 7 equal to minus of 4.85 kilonewton meter. The answer to the problem, work done for isothermal process 37.15 kilonewton meter, for polytropic process minus 35 kilonewton meter, for constant pressure process minus 7 kilonewton meter, and for the cycle minus of 4.85 kilonewton meter. And another example, similar example, a piston cylinder device operates 1 kg of fluid at 20 atmospheric pressure. So the initial volume is 0.04 meter cube. The fluid is allowed to expand reversibly following the process. PV to the power 1.45 equal to constant. And so that the volume becomes double. The fluid is then cooled at constant pressure until the piston come back to the original position. And the piston, keeping the piston unaltered, the heat is added reversibly to restore its original pressure. Calculate the work done in the cycle. So, first process 1 to 2 is Paul Troy process, where n equal to 1.45, 2 to 3 is constant pressure process, and 3 to 1 is constant volume process. So, the values are given here. So, for Paul Troy process, P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power n. So, 20 into 0.04 divided by 0.08. So, V2 equal to 2 times of V1. So, to the power 1.45 equal to 7.32 atmosphere. And the work done equal to P1 into V1 minus P2 V2 to be N minus 1. So P1 20 into 101.325. 101 atmosphere equal to 101.325 kilopascal. So 20 into 101.325 into 0.04 minus 7.32 into 101.325 into 0.08 divided by 1.45 minus 1 is 48.275 kilonewton meter. For constant pressure process, work done equal to P2 into V3 minus V2. That is equal to 7.32 into 101.325 into 0.04 minus 0.08 equal to minus of 29.66 kilonewton meter. For constant volume process, there is no work done, W31 equal to 0. And the net work done for the cycle, W equal to W12 plus W23 plus W31 equal to 48.275 minus 29.66 equal to 18.6 kilonewton meter. So the answer to the problem, the work done for the pilot drive process, 48.275 kilonewton meter. Work done for the constant pressure process, minus 29.66 kilonewton meter. Work done for the constant volume process equal to 0. And the cycle, work done for the cycle equal to 18.6 kilonewton meter. And these are all the reference book I used for solving the, preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And if you have any queries or the comments on the video, you can write to my mail ID. I will answer. So thank you for watching. We'll meet again.